Hello and welcome to the Loras College Rock Bowl. I'm Hugh Malone and this is my co-anchor, EJ Greenberg. EJ, how you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing great, Hugh. I'm happy to be back in the Rock Bowl for some Loras College football.
So am I. We both know that there's a lot of talent out here on the Rock Bowl today, but there are always some players to keep your eye on. Who are you looking for the Duhawks today?
Well, for offense, I think it starts with Noah Sigworth, the fifth-year quarterback. You know, he's been a leader for this team for a long, long time. And we'll see. If he can limit turnovers today, I think the Duhawks have a good chance. And then defensively, we got two other fifth-years, Sam Jones and Jack Foley. Sam, number 98, defensive end. He's going to get in the backfield a lot, hopefully a lot of tackles for a loss. And if Eau Claire does decide to pass the ball, they probably won't decide to pass it to Jack Foley's side, as we've seen a lot of teams have been afraid to throw it to his side in years past.
Yeah, I'm excited to see how Sigworth plays in his final season. And then on defense side, I'm really looking forward to watching Sam affect the passing game. And then, like you said, if they even throw it to Jack to watch him bat those balls and get some interceptions. Now, who are you looking for on the Eau Claire side of the ball?
Well, I think Eau Claire. You look at last game's box score. Austin Belot had 365 rushing yards. Good for the school record. Also tacked on three touchdowns. His 365 rushing yards were fourth all-time in the conference. And the conference that is known as the SEC of D3 football, a major, major conference. So that is no number to bat an eye at. And then defensively, Vic Martinelli, he's second-team all-conference as a freshman, and I heard the Duhawks are preparing a lot for him coming off the edge.
Yeah, the Duhawks have themselves a handful for today's game, but so does Eau Claire with the experience that the Duhawks are bringing back from last season. And as the coin flip, Eau Claire won that, so they elected to defer. So Duhawks will be receiving it first. And back for the Duhawks is Ty Bausch and Eli Thomas. Eli Thomas, an electric player on the field.
Absolutely. Both of the returners are. Eli was an all-American returner his freshman year.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is officially Duhawk football at the Rock Bowl. Eli Thomas gets the ball. Reads his blocks, hits the hole, and he's tackled at the around the 25-yard line.
Kind of surprised to see that they kicked it to Eli. I know a lot of teams like to kick it to Ty. Neither are really great options, I would say.
Pick your poison type of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm really looking forward to see how this offense plays. I mean, 2-0 last season in the spring. All their other games got canceled due to COVID, but I think with all this time they've had, I think they're going to look real sharp.
Yeah, and a lot of returning players this year, so the Duhawks season does look to be very promising this year.
And I know last week it was a little rough for them because they had three linemen out, so they couldn't really move the ball on the line.
Yeah, so they had three linemen out due to COVID, and they had 39 rushing yards and just under a yard per attempt, so that was tough. But that had to do a lot to do with the three linemen being out.
Thankfully, all the two out of three linemen are back. The starting center, Ben Bogman, still out, so they have Eli Denton, a freshman, starting at center today. Sigworth gets the snap, throws it high, it goes through his hands, incomplete.
A little too hot to handle right there out of the gates. Is
incomplete. A little bit of nerves maybe, too, first home game of the season.
Yeah. It's good to see the Rock Bowl back, vibrant with all these people.
A lot of people here.
Yeah.
And just to smell the concession stands and everything, too.
Yep, all the parents were out there getting tailgating, getting ready.
Eli in motion. Sigworth keeps it. Gets a gain of about three before he's hit.
Had a little option play right there. Duhawks love to run the option plays with Siggy being such a great athlete as he is.
And Eli's a running back, but he's a player that can play anywhere on the field. He was lined up as a wide receiver that play. And the sophomore, Javon Williams, just came into the game for the Duhawks.
He made an amazing catch last week.
I'm really looking forward to see how he plays this season because he was a pretty big focal point last season.
Even as a freshman. Mm-hmm.
Sigworth gets the ball. Looking deep. He's got a man. Overthrow him. Eli kind of got hit there by the defender, and he was trying to make that wheel route.
Yeah, that was good defense there by Eau Claire. Three and out for the Duhawks.
Hopefully we don't see a whole lot of this today. Farfan, Nick Farfan, the senior punter for the Duhawks.
Yep, back for his fifth year.
Returning for Eau Claire is Alex Mashak, the senior. F- Farfan's punt is up.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's a little short. A little bit of a iffy bounce there.
Yeah, that's not at all what you wanted from that punt right there. An already potent offense. We had around 500 rushing yards last game, getting the ball right at the 50. It's not.
And these guys are – we were talking earlier pregame how big this offensive line is.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a challenge for the Duhawks defensive line, I'd say.
Yeah, this offensive line looks like your classic homegrown, like Wisconsin farmer boys. Like, they did not miss any milk. They're strong, you know?
Yeah. I'd say this first play almost have to be a run to Austin with how we performed last week against Luther. And it is a handoff to Austin. He got a few good blocks, and he's knocked out of bounds by number three, Brett Bauer.
Brett Bauer had a pretty good game last week. He had a fumble recovery and an interception. Hopefully he can do that again today.
That would be huge for the Duhawks to cause some turnovers. It'd really help them out.
Yeah. Last year, or 2 years ago when they played 2019, the Duhawks came on the wrong side of the ball, losing 35-3. But this Eau Claire team, they've brought a lot of guys back, but so has this Duhawks team, so it should be a pretty good game.
Yeah, Duhawks have a lot of leadership on this defense especially. And like you said earlier, Duhawks brought almost every senior back for that fifth-year option, so that's always good. As Austin gets the handoff and he stays up after the first hit, and then he's brought down by a group of Duhawks pretty close to the first down marker.
Yeah, that's what we're going to see a lot today, a lot of Austin B-Lot, a lot of ground and pound. Their offensive line's got a pretty good push so far the first couple plays. We'll see how Sam Jones and the rest of the D-line responds.
And I know their quarterback in 2019, he played 5 games, and he only threw for about 360 yards. So they're really ground-and-pound-centered offense.
Yeah.
And their 2020 season was canceled due to COVID, so we didn't get much of those stats either.
Yeah.
Eau Claire sends a man in motion to fake. He gets his man wide. Oh, and he drops the ball. He had room to run. I think that's why he dropped it. Turned his head too early.
Yeah. It was a nice bootleg right there, but just couldn't handle the ball. I think the D-Lots got kind of surprised by that pass right there.
I think if Eau Claire does a lot of play actions, that they might open up a little downfield shots with the way Austin performed last week for them.
Yeah. We'll see how the Foley brothers can respond out there.
They got that brother dynamic out there.
Yes,
clamp everybody up.
The Foley Island.
I send a man in motion again. Back around. Austin gets the ball. Hits his hole. Oh, good stop there by the Duhawks. Gained about 5 yards, though.
It's Josh Kiefer. Led the Duhawks in tackles last week with 6.
And I remember last week, the real backbreaker for the Duhawks was the kickoff return for the touchdown against them.
Yeah, it was momentum seemed to start going on the Duhawks side finally, and then right after they scored, Norbert had a nice kick return to take it to the house.
That's always tough to have that happen to you.
Yeah. The Duhawks struggled stopping the run against Norbert last week too, so we'll see how they do today.
They head off to their freshman running back, Ivan Rubel, who's brought down by another group of Duhawks, and I believe there's a flag on the play.
Last game for Eau Claire to beat Luther 45-14, and last year the Duhawks beat Luther 45-21, so that's pretty comparable, I would
say. Yeah, it is. A lot of discussion over what the penalty is here.
Still talk. I think they're.
I think the Duhawks shine if they wanted to decline it or accept it.
Yeah.
Do you think Eau Claire's going to go for it here? Kind of in a no man's land?
We'll see after this.
Looks like the offense still out here.
Yeah. I'd be surprised if they ran it at this distance. So, wow, I'm kind of surprised they are going, trusting their passing game this much.
Or maybe they'll just try and draw somebody offside with a hard count.
I'd not be surprised. The Duhawks bring on the pass rushing unit, bringing on the two outside linebackers off the edge.
Oh, nobody in the backfield. 5 wide. gets snap. Dumps it off. Oh! The Duhawks get the ball. They run up the field. One man to beat. Nice tackle there by the quarterback for Eau Claire, but you just love to see that from the Duhawks. Get that nice little interception there.
Yeah, great play. He tried. It almost looked like they like tried to run RPO. A little quarterback power, and at the last second he decided to pitch it, and Josh Oglesby was right there.
It's almost like he just ripped it out of Austin's hands, too.
Yeah. Josh Oglesby, the junior out of Nazareth High School.
That was electric.
Yeah.
Especially hearing the crowd going, too.
Mm-hmm. Maybe get the offense going. Mm-hmm.
If you were the offense coordinator here, what would you be your first play coming out of that? Would you take a chunk play, go for the end zone?
Yeah,
maybe?
I might look for Marty McGovern. He had a nice game last week, 4 catches and a touchdown. Or I wouldn't be surprised if they put the ball in Ty's hands right here.
Sigworth in the backfield with Ty. Play fake.
Oh!
The freshman, Monty Williams, did not expect that ball to be coming to him because he was not looking towards it.
Yeah, it almost seems like he thought it was a run play. Mm-hmm. He was... It wasn't even facing the ball.
Yeah, I guess you'll have those learning curves, though, with those freshmen starting.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. With Cabron Cook being hurt and out, the guys had to step up.
Another play-action pass, a little screen fake. Eli Thomas hit behind the line.
The Duhawk offense just seems a little bit off right now. It seems like
that play was almost doomed from the beginning.
Yeah, they're not on the same page right about
now. Now, I'd say it's obviously going to be a pass here third and 11.
Yeah. I like what they were trying to do that play, though. Get your most dangerous man in some space. Yeah. You know, make some people miss. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're playing real off Eli out there on the... Sigworth gets it. Oh, pressured immediately. Run away from the defender. He's got room to run. Oh, and he gets the first down.
What a run. Wow.
That's just great playmaking by Sigworth to avoid the pressure and get that first down for the Duhawks, keep the chains moving.
Yeah, he had no time to pass right there. He was running like a chicken with his head cut off right there and somehow still managed to get the first down.
I'm surprised he was able to stay up after he got hit that first time.
Yeah.
Hit him with the stiff arm and kept going.
Siggy is like one of those guys you just love when he's your quarterback because he's not afraid to stay in bounds and give someone the shoulder.
Oh, yeah. And he's in all alone in the backfield. Screen. Oh, little QB run here. Spin move for about 5 yards. Now the Duhawk offense might have a little life to him after that run.
Yeah. So far, the only thing that's worked has been Siggy putting on the deck and running.
He's all alone in the backfield again is what it looks like for this play, too. I've noticed they've tried to get a lot of screen passes going on early here as well.
Yeah.
They got a lot of motion, too. Oh, almost looked like an offsides there.
Yeah.
Nice little shovel pass for the first down.
Same play Eau Claire turned the ball over on.
Mike McDevitt there with that. Gets the Duhawks a first down.
McDevitt's fifth-year senior out of St. Rita High School. He played receivers first 3 years, and last year they switched him over to tight end, so he had to bulk up a little bit.
And I believe he just came out of the play for that one, for this play. And Eli checked back in. I'd almost think
weapons.
They'd have to give it to Eli right here on this motion, maybe. Oh, yep, little screen. Took 3 Eau Claire defenders to bring him down there.
Yeah. Eau Claire did a good job swarming to the ball right there. I'm sure they're prepared very heavily for Eli.
This is huge for the Duhawks to get a touchdown here, take an early lead.
Yeah.
The pistol formation here for the Duhawks. Sigworth and Bosch. Sigworth looking for his man. Overthrows McDevitt in the end zone. Okay. That's the right play there, though.
Yeah.
Either put it where your guy can't get it or nobody gets it.
You can't have a turnover here. You need to at least come out with 3. At least.
Yeah. And Farfan's almost an automatic type kicker, too, so... I believe he's a fifth-year senior as well.
Yep.
What will the Duhawks be doing here? A pass or a run, do you think?
Yeah, they gotta pass it here.
Eli is out of the game for the Duhawks, too. Throwing it up to his receiver. McGrubbin, no good. Fourth down for the Duhawks.
That was a good ball by Siggy right there. Yeah. Marty just couldn't come down with it.
Almost Moss's defender, too. Yeah. That would have been a nice play.
Marty stepped into that number one receiver role now that Cabron is out and McDevitt's transitioned to tight end.
And Marty had a touchdown last week
as
well.
Big game last week.
Sigworth the holder here, and Farfan will be kicking for 3 points. The kick is up, and it's blocked. And Eau Claire has it at their own 13-yard line. You know, I saw when we were in here pregame, I saw Farfan kicking. He was struggling a little bit in pregame.
That was Eau Claire is just, they got some big guys that are getting the push so far against these Duhawks. I'm kind of surprised that Eau Claire just fell on it there. It looked like that guy had a lot of room to run.
Maybe he just stumbled over his own feet, possibly.
That's what I would guess.
It would have, Sigworth would have had been the one to bring him down, so it would have been a foot race.
Yep.
Now, hopefully the Duhawks can stop the Eau Claire from driving all the way down the field and scoring. That would be a real, hurt to the team if they did that.
Yep.
Duhawks stack in the box here. Eau Claire sends a man in motion. They hand it to Austin. Austin, good little gain of 8 yards there.
Talk about a workhorse, Austin. B-Lot, man.
And if he keeps getting gains like that, they're never going to get off. Duhawk defense is going to be on the field all day, basically.
I wouldn't be surprised if he ends this year with, like, 200 carries almost.
Yeah.
Like, they feed this guy the rock a lot.
I mean, why not with how he played against Luther?
Exactly.
I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Exactly.
Jonathan Malug is the quarterback under center. Sends one of his mans in motion. Oh, play fake. Looking to air it out. A little bit of a bad ball, but good defending by Brett Bauer. Almost, he could have almost had a play on that ball if he...
Eau Claire is begging for pass interference right now. Yeah, if Brett would have turned around, I think he could have the easy pick.
A little bit of an underthrown ball.
Yeah, I'm almost surprised that they didn't throw the PI right there. Usually, no matter what, if they don't get their head around, they're going to toss it.
Yeah. Maybe from our angle, though, could have been not a whole lot of contact or something.
Yeah. Yeah, it didn't look like he really knocked him off
his
way.
I mean, he put his hands up, too, so I mean.
Yeah.
But sometimes that's always a ploy for that you did something wrong, too. So.
Right. DBs do love to throw their hands up even when the quarterback just overthrew them. And
Jonathan sends one of his receivers in motion. Going for a pass again. Oh, and they throw a flag on this one.
Yep. Looked like Zah kind
of
grabbed him
right
there. Yeah. Zacchaeus Knighton, the junior out of Florida.
I've noticed a lot of Florida guys on this Duhawk football team.
They heavily recruit Florida.
And we've got a lot of talent, so
that's
always good.
Got guys like Big Sean Corglass,
the anchor of that offensive line.
Yep.
I almost thought that ball was a little uncatchable, so I didn't know if they would throw the flag.
Yeah,
or not.
That wasn't a great throw.
I guess Eau Claire got that call they wanted a play ago. So
yep.
Two pass plays in a row, kind of shocked, honestly.
Yeah. I feel like the odds of that had to be super low, two in a row.
Looks like they have their freshman running back, Ivan Rubel, in the backfield. They hand it off to him. Makes one guy miss in the backfield, but it's stood up by Brett Bauer. Brett Bauer's just been everywhere these first couple plays.
Yeah, he's all over the place. That's what you want from your safety, though, a guy. Be that linebacker and also be that cornerback.
And the times they have thrown it hasn't been at Foley either.
No. No surprise there.
They know where he's at.
Yeah.
They got Austin Belot in the backfield now. Second down, I don't want to say they try and get a little bit of a run play here. Oh, yep, a reverse. Oh, makes a man miss and is hit again by Brett Bauer.
There to clean up Blaine Jordan. Couldn't bring him down.
That would have been huge for him to bring him down. third down here, almost has to be a pass.
100% has to be.
And it was David Anthony who ran that last ball for Eau Claire on the reverse.
Wouldn't be surprised if they try to get B-Lot like out in motion or in some space here. Try to make a guy miss, mm-hmm. run someone over.
Yeah. Rolls out of the pocket. Oh, and had a man right on the sticks who caught it.
Good play design. This quick little mm-hmm. curl right there.
Yeah. Good job by the receiver knowing where the sticks were, too. Yep.
Awareness is everything.
I believe that was Eau Claire's first completed pass, too.
Yeah. Their passing game has looked way better than I thought so far.
Mm-hmm,
the quarterback,
too, yeah.
He's made some decent throws. He had a couple of drops, though.
I'd say. I haven't seen a whole lot of... I thought they'd give the ball to Austin Bielot a little bit more here than what they have, but
yeah.
Maybe that's part of their game plan. Almost use him as a decoy. But as on cue, they give him the ball for about 3 yards.
Eau Claire holds the all-time series record, too, at 2-0.
Hopefully the Duox can make that 2-1.
Yep.
That'd be a great way to start your home opener of the season just with a win. Especially against a team like Eau Claire, too.
Yeah.
A good team, come from a good conference. It'd really help the Duhawks' confidence.
Eau Claire, when they beat the Duhawks in 2019, went just 1-6 in conference. So that just shows you how legitimate their
mm-hmm.
conference
yeah.
is.
Another pass here for Eau Claire. And the quarterback gets hit as he throws it and is incomplete.
I believe that was Josh Jones on the blitz right there. Make him hurry up.
Gave a good hit to the quarterback after, too. Third down and 9 here for Eau Claire Blue Gold. As Austin Bielot comes out of the game.
Got Josh at Oglesby and Brett McWilliams back on the field.
And out wide for the cornerbacks is Jack Foley and Zacharias Knighton. Duhawks playing press coverage on the outside. Oh, they hand it off. And he's brought down at the 50-yard line.
Brett McWilliams and Blaine Jordan.
Good job storming to the ball there for the Duhawks. Almost looks like, oh, nope, offense coming off the field. I almost thought maybe since they ran it, they might have gone for it.
Yeah. Defensive battle so far.
Mm-hmm. And I know you like that, a former defensive
oh,
player.
Yeah. I love low-scoring games, gritty, running in between the boxes, like Army-Navy games. Those are always
mm-hmm,
awesome.
Yeah. The punter for Eau Claire is Nate Baranek, a junior from Dupree, Wisconsin. And he's kicking it to Ty Bausch.
Line drive kick.
Good open field tackle there for Eau Claire.
Yeah, you do not see Ty Bausch get tackled mm-hmm. by the first guy, maybe ever. That literally could be the first time I think I've seen him
yeah,
get tackled.
Yeah, and it was either have him get tackled in the open field or block in the back.
Yeah.
So, I mean.
What makes Ty so dangerous in the open field is his footwork. Like, the way he can stop on a dime and then just go right back to full speed in the blink of an eye. Mm-hmm. And he has the great little, like, pitter-patter almost with his feet where he reads the defense, reads what you think he's going to do, and then he does the opposite.
What everybody looks for in a running back.
Exactly.
Sigworth and Ty in the backfield. Sigworth hands it off to Ty. Ty had a little bit of a hole there, and he took advantage of it for about a gain of 5.
There we go. There's a good push mm-hmm. there by the O-line.
And this O-line, a lot of experience up front except for the freshman they got starting at center, and that's due to a couple injuries for the Duhawks.
Yeah, just unlucky health-wise on the O-line so mm-hmm. far for the Duhawks.
It's always tough, too, O-line. Always getting hit every play.
Yeah.
Always in a squat, too. Ty brought down around the line of scrimmage, a little behind it. Brings up third down for the Duhawks. You really got to hope that they got to move the ball here. You
yeah.
can't. You'd be losing the field position battle.
You got to flip the field. This defense is going out there, stopping the guy who mm-hmm. rushed for 350 yards last
yeah.
week. The offense.
Need a little bit of a break.
Yeah.
Javon is in motion. Sigworth gets the snap, has to move out of the pocket, and he is sacked. The O-line kind of just got blown up there.
Yeah.
And Sigworth got brought down for the sack.
We haven't seen too much of Vic Martinelli so far. We haven't called his name at all.
No, we haven't.
As a freshman in 2019, he was second team all-conference. So,
a lot of potential for him. Hopefully Farfan's punt this time is a little better than his last one. Also, he's got the wind at his back, too, so hopefully that'll give it a little bit of a boost.
Yeah.
Farfan's punt is up. Got a nice little spiral there.
Oh!
He dropped it. Oh, looks like he recovered on it, though.
Oh, Claire's getting a good push against the personal protectors of Loras. Both punts. One thing I'd say so far, Eau Claire just seems to be a little more physical than the Duhawks right now.
And it almost has to be that offensive line for Eau Claire. Those big bodies up front.
Setting the tone.
And Austin, too. Austin Belot for Eau Claire. He's just another big body, too.
Going to have Derrick Henry high school numbers at the end of this season.
Oh, yeah. Especially with the Duhawk defense being out there so much, eventually it's going to start taking a toll on them.
Yeah. Late in the game.
Belock gets the handoff. Runs for about 7 yards before he's hit at the knees.
I think that's Jace Gwynn making the tackle right there.
I remember the game last year. We called Jace Gwynn with that big interception.
Yeah, and he had just switched to corner that week.
Yeah.
Former wide receiver.
A lot of talent for this Duhawk cornerback squad.
Yep. A lot of experience, too.
Malug under center with Rubel in the backfield. Hands it off to his wide receiver in motion, who's brought down close to the first down marker, and that was David Antoni.
It's brought down by Josh Rydberg.
This is a big third down here for the Duhawks, but I'd almost have to think if Eau Claire doesn't get it, they'd go for it.
I would imagine so.
I think it's going to be a pass or two run plays here.
If I was Eau Claire, I'm running the ball both times.
Yeah.
I'm handing it to my workhorse, letting my best player try to make a play.
Oh, Austin Belot's not in the game, though. Looks like it's Ivan Rubel in the backfield with Jonathan Malug. Oh, it's a pass. Yeah. Has his man for the first down.
Even with the throw being a little high.
Looks like the receiver's hurt as well after that tackle.
Oh, no.
Number 6, Brandon O'Loughlin. You just hate to see that.
Yeah, you want to see that throw a little lower.
You got to hope he's okay after a tackle like that. I always hate to see injuries.
Especially early on in the season. Both receivers, though, ran a couple good routes. I think both of them open.
Yeah.
Seems like every time Eau Claire has gone back to pass, the Duhawks have been a little thrown off.
Yeah. Do you see who made the tackle there for the Duhawks?
Yeah, I believe it was Josh Rydberg again. Pride of Roscoe, Illinois. Hanoniga High School. Trainer's running back to the sideline here.
He's definitely going... Brandon will definitely need some assistance getting off the field. Always sad to see that.
Yeah.
And looks like they're bringing the stretcher out.
It's just a shame, man.
And he's a junior, too, so you hope he can bounce back from this injury.
A lot of players taking the knee right now. Yeah, last game they averaged 12 per carry. So Duhawks have definitely been holding to a better pace so far.
That's good to see the Duhawks game plan paying off so far. for what they've been practicing.
I mean, 12 a carry is just insane. That's a
first down every run.
Yeah. I think Luther might have like Swiss cheese on defense the way
after that.
Yeah.
After what happened there.
Yeah.
And he's able to stand up and hop to the stretcher. That's always. At least he could get up.
Yeah, at least he didn't have to lift him.
And looked like he has an air cast on that left leg of his. As his teammates go over there, give him words of encouragement.
Yeah, the injury there did not. This no, it's going to land.
But hopefully he's able.
Let's see if that's a little lower. I think he'd probably be fine right now. Because it seemed like Rydberg, he tackled him at
when he was in the air.
He's in the air, and so when he came down and landed, I think he kind of folded over a little bit.
Yeah. The Eau Claire quarterback now looks like he'll be under center with Austin Belot field. Duhawks aren't stacking the box as much as they were earlier in the game, but they're still runs. Sends his receiver in motion, hands it to Austin Belot, who's stopped right around the line of scrimmage by the Duhawks.
Defensive line allowing an inch right there. Eau Claire's used a lot of motion, too, so far, trying to get the eyes of the defense going somewhere else.
Looks like Brandon Phelps there on the tackle.
Hawks. Eau Claire's head second full year. 2019 was his first, but last year, like we said earlier, didn't play any games due to COVID.
Looking to really build this program up even stronger. They hand it to Bielak, brought down again. Duhawks are really keeping them under wraps for the most part.
Yeah, the first drive, we had a couple since then. Tackled at the line or just passed almost every play.
Defensive coordinator Greg Bauer is probably making those in between when the offense out there is probably making those adjustments.
Absolutely. Great Bauer.
And that looks like it'll be the end of the first quarter. At the end of the first, Ulog 0, Eau Claire Blue Golds 0 as well. Got a defensive battle here.
Yeah, defensive battle so far. Both teams struggled moving the ball. We'd like to see Loras, when they go back to pass, to see if he can get something going.
Yeah.
And then the defense has done a good job of this, and you keep it.
Yeah, Sigworth has had little to no time in the pocket.
Yeah, he's...
It's been his, like, face. Hard to do.
That's been the struggle for Loras these last couple of years. Given running backs.
All going on today in Duhawk. The Loras soccer team in a big game again. You, who's ranked fourth in the nation, and if they win this game, it's a good chance for them to get a bid at the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, huge game. Oshawa powerhouse, so hopefully the Duhawks come out on top.
And that game also kicked off at 1 o'clock, so we'll be giving updates on that. Also going on, say, to Iowa, this game.
Yeah.
Go Cyclones. Game day in Ames, too.
Yeah.
You know, they've been against Iowa the past few years, but they've got Purdy ball. I mean, they got a lot of All-Americans out there. They're going to be looking good
If there's ever a year, this is the
year. Maybe they'll even be a playoff team.
Yeah, we'll see.
One can only hope.
Yeah, they're going to have to be Oklahoma.
Yeah.
So let's get a little bit of gust of wind.
A little wind in the air booth.
Might come in factor on this third down where they're going to have to.
Third here for Eau Claire Blue Gold. And the sends a man in motion. Gets the snap, hops back, has a man good. Pass there, fourth down.
Yeah, good defense there by the Duhawks. He had and he couldn't wait. Yeah. He's going to take a sack.
Looks like they're going for it.
Yeah, they're in their in-between range right now. Too long to kick, but you don't want to punt.
So. Yeah, you get yards off of a punt.
And also, why wouldn't you trust your defense if you're Eau Claire so far?
Yeah. Been able to. Loras hasn't the ball a lot.
Mm-mm.
I mean, the farthest they've been was off the interception.
Oh,
looks like
punt.
It was a punt.
Don't hit it.
Oh, a good bounce for Eau Claire
that
there.
That was a great pooch punch.
Looks like the Duhawks will be on their own 8-yard line, which is kind of worrisome with the way they've been moving the ball today.
I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Olson, the offensive coordinator for Loras, is going to call some plays, maybe trying to get Siggy moving outside the pocket, looking for some passes. You know, trying
some
to
design roll.
Built in some more time.
And this is a good quarterback on the run quarterback.
Yeah.
You just hope he gets more time out.
Yeah.
Looks like Michael Cross lined up out wide for the Duhawks.
My roommate.
Ty Bausch gets the ball. He's pushing forward for a gain of 7.
Good carry, Ty.
There's about 3 guys on him. He's moving.
That's the other thing great about Ty. Not only can he make a miss, but he'll run through. He's a strong kid, athlete.
Mm-hmm. Got Eli and Ty in the game. Duhawks in formation. Gun now over to him. A little bit of a reverse. Sigworth land. Sock.
See, that's what I was saying earlier. You'd love playing with this. He's not afraid to throw. Takes.
The Duhawks in the first quarter had 6 rushes for 24 yards, but Eau Claire only had 39 rushing yards off 13 attempts, so
yeah.
Duhawks really keeping them under wraps here.
Both barely yards in the first quarter.
Ty.
Keep feeding them, I'd say. It's working.
Here for the Duhawks.
The line change here.
This is probably the most almost all game. Almost really.
Yeah.
Eli's checked out of the game. Siggy and Ty in the backfield. Play fake. Rolling out.
Oh,
looking out.
Oh, pass interference.
We were talking about earlier, Michael Crawford.
Yeah. My roommate. Go.
Nice play out there. I am the. Almost caught that ball, too. He made a good play on it.
St. Pat. Illinois.
Good ball by Siggy, too.
Yeah.
Especially on the run, too.
I wonder if Coach Olson liked that decision, though. I bet he was holding his breath that whole time. The ball was in the air. But, you know, you can't hit it. You got to try to make something happen.
Well, haven't been moving the ball a whole lot. Why not get the ball a little bit? I believe this came out of the backfield for
his upper course.
Mm-hmm. Siggy with another play fake. Thrown to the freshman, Monty.
Maybe could have been another pass call. Something.
Got a little bit of hell, and he went to 10 for it. Sigworth's been looking at the freshman. Monty Brown for a few passes now. That's got to be a boat of confidence for the freshman.
Saying Monty Brown's going to be insane for you. Loras, he's an athlete, great hands, can do it all.
You love to hear that for the future of the program as Sean comes off the line.
Maybe oh, never mind.
Oh. But it's like happens. Corn was looks like the cleaning up what happened on the field.
Yeah, there's a little bit of throw up on the field.
Especially on a day like this, it was important for them to stay hydrated and everything like that. The sun beating on them.
Hot day. And they be honest, they haven't played much football recently, what they've been playing their whole lives. Yeah. They've had last year only two games.
I mean, there's a little bit of a breeze, too. That helps, but nothing in hydrated like this.
I remember one time freshman tired at practice. The center literally threw up like before the snap. Like inches to
an effective way to
let's just say there wasn't there wasn't a pass in the middle. Yeah.
Hopefully Sean will get back in this game soon. The anchor of that offensive line.
Yeah. Hopefully it was just a little bit of overheating for a second or something like that. Nothing serious.
Sigworth and Eli on the backfield. In the pistol formation. Sigworth steps back and is lit up. He's about to throw it.
Good decision there not to throw it because who knows where that throw would have gone once he got hit.
Eli, had Eli stay in the block there, he could have picked that guy up.
Yeah, he just came untouched off the edge.
I believe that was their linebacker, Spencer Van Peter. Who made that sack there? And they got Vic Martinelli right there in the middle. Steps back. No. Oh, but he stays. See, but a dance and back to the original scrimmage before he's driven out of bounds.
Insane play by Siggy. Once again, he had no time once again. And somehow made something.
Yeah. Got about 7 yards there. Bring him back to the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah, reminds me of like Patrick Mahomes in the Super Bowl. You know, they had two offensive linemen out. Yeah. He's running all over the place, making plays, no passes.
Yeah. Our fans take though, so. Punt
here. And I feel like first one, he kind of got short legged a little bit.
Maybe hit off the foot wrong or something. Snap, but Farfan gets it up.
That is his best punt so far, I would say.
And Eau Claire Fair caught that. They'll be on their
fifth-year buddy coming in the game as safety.
A lot of fifth-years on this duo.
It's a close-knit group, you know. They all came.
That's always good to have those guys who've been together, been through the ups and downs of a program, and they have that each other's going to be.
And it's huge for the freshman, I'd say, too, just seeing how do you play college. Like,
family and a team and all that stuff.
Exactly. Here, complete it.
That was a big boy that they just brought down there for the Duke.
I believe that was number 85 for Eau Claire.
Isaac Garside. First to do. I mean, for the
Blue Gold, not a great nickname.
Not nearly as good as the Duhawks.
Yeah.
Like Austin Belot. They hand it off to him and he lit up.
Let's go. Jack Foley.
Not throwing the balls away, so he says, let me get on this and brings down Austin at the line of scrimmage.
That's the other thing that's great about Jack Foley. He's going to get dirty. He's going to get his nose there in there on the run.
Mm-hmm.
And he had tackle for a loss last week.
And he's no small guy either.
Like a linebacker, but can guard clearly the fastest receiver on a team.
And it looks like he's guarding their tight end right now, Joe Swanson. As a linebacker, injured a Blue Gold. A little overheating again.
Another break here. Last game for Siggy, though. 17-31, 166 through the air, one touchdowns, two picks, and one rushing touchdown. It seemed like the Duhawk passing game had looked the best I've seen in a while, for sure.
And two interceptions got to be chalked up to the inexperienced line.
Yeah. Yeah, you have bad picks by Siggy, I would say. Then I think they had one sack also last week. Offensive lineman for Eau Claire still down.
He's not moving.
Yeah.
It's always scary.
Yeah.
Duhawks side like Sean's ready to go back in.
That's good. Coach H talking to him right now. Probably didn't need him.
Yeah.
Hate to see this.
All the trainers over there for both teams.
Hopefully we can get another
because
it's gone right now. Trainers are over the place. Hopefully everyone's staying hydrated out there.
Especially after seeing this too happen too.
Belot only had 7 in the first half, averaging 3.
And then the Duhawks with the one turnover that forced, obviously.
Josh Rydberg with 3 tackles. He, even though he was only in for a possession, I believe he got tackles on all.
Farfan's averaging 13.5 yards. That's
tough. That is abysmal. Oh, we got the
Gator coming out.
Hopefully they can get him up here.
Yeah. Also looking at last quarter stats, only one team's been in the red zone so far, and that was the Duhawks off of the turnover they first.
That blocked kick was huge, because if we'll see a score, it's been a defensive battle.
Yeah. And the Blue Golds are winning the time of right now. They have 4 more minutes than the Duhawks.
Oh, he's standing. Is he going to get on the Gator?
Glad to see him
get up. That was a good thing about these injuries. At least they're able to get up and walk.
Yeah. And that was their big left tackle, Drew Schrader. 6'3", 274 pounds. That's just a force to be reckoned with out there, too.
Yeah, we talked about this run game is a focal point. So losing your starting tackle, that's huge.
Looks like on their depth chart, looks like it's a freshman up next for him.
Mm-hmm.
What do we got? Second.
Austin Belot's lined up in the tight end spot there for the blue gold with the Rubel in the back. And they hand it off to Bot.
Oh,
who
no.
Makes one guy miss and then down by the guy who missed him the first time.
Rushing inside by number 5.
Wait, did not give over the play right there. Run to the ball. I know that's what Coach Bauer preaches a lot. Everyone run to the ball.
All about hustle with Coach Bauer. Game started to really slow down compared to the first quarter.
Yeah. Third and about 7 here. We got the pass rushers on.
Looks like Eau Claire called the timeout. The play clock was running down there for Eau Claire, so I had to burn a timeout.
Yeah. Never want to do that, though. Valuable.
Speaking of Coach Bauer and Coach Bauer hustling, he farmed 30 minutes, helped me take down one of our sheds that we took down.
Oh, really?
I was talking to Ball and about the he's bringing back, and he said he's had to bring all the defense seniors back, and he's really excited for what this defense can do this upcoming.
Yeah, the defense is one of the top defenses in the American River Conference, I would say.
Mm-hmm. And there's some really good teams in the American Rivers Conference as well, too.
Oh, yeah.
So,
UD's always most years always a powerhouse. Central.
Just really looking forward to all the home games we get to call as well.
Yeah, last year only
I won.
Yeah. Oh yeah. One was away. That's
and the shot gun for me rolls out of the pocket. Oh, ball tipped. Good defense there by the Duhawks.
Josh Oglesby getting his on the ball again.
And everywhere.
Because he was open. A good chance leader if he didn't get a hand on it.
Hopefully Ty can make something happen on this return here too. A little bark going to the Duhawks on offense. Defense has been
big return. Huge. Mm-hmm. Momentum wise too.
Blue Gold's punt is up. Ty gets it. Stiff. He brings him around the 22-yard line. Duhawks taking over about where they left off in that same spot, really.
The Blue Gold's gunners have had an amazing day so far. Tackling Ty is no easy thing to do, but yeah. They've made it seem very easy so far.
And the punter for the Blue Gold, Nate Baranek, he's done a pretty solid job for the few points.
Given the time, so those guys can get back there.
About the hang the distance. Hard to get both of them right.
Yeah.
It's either usually a long punt or it just hangs up in the air and doesn't go anywhere. Sigworth looking for a man. Airing it out to Mon. There's the flag. Good job by Monty. A nice ball by Siggy.
I like it. Duhawk offense looking deep.
Brady Underwood flagged for the Blue Gold on that play. He's a little confused on why the flag was thrown.
Well, I don't think anyone else is.
Yeah. I mean, right away, we were saying how that was pass interference.
The Eau Claire's coaches didn't seem to buy that one either.
Yeah.
So.
It's kind of all over him, never looked for the ball or anything. Looks like he'll be matched up on for this play. Sigworth handoff to Ty, was met immediately in the back. Oh, flag thrown. I don't want to say it'd be a late blue gold. Dove on Ty when he was already down.
Yeah, we're Tom.
Spencer Van Peterson, the one who was flagged for the taunting there, and the coaches cannot be happy about that.
No.
The Duhawks free from that and struggling to move the ball.
Their defense is stopping them. The last thing you need to do is just give them another opportunity.
Yeah. I'm sure you're getting near coaches about that one. Ty and Sigwa in the backfield. Siggy with the play fake. Airing it out. He's
Go.
Got a man.
Oh.
Looking to hit Marty McGovern there. Almost had him, too. A little bit.
It's a little too much mustard on it.
Second and 10. If the Duhawks would have got that, would have been huge.
Yeah.
The crowd would have erupted. Yeah. They're just waiting for something to happen
One
here.
Big thing in this stadium can go nuts.
There's a pretty good crowd here, too.
Yeah, great. Duhawks always have great fans.
Good to see everybody back out here. Worth airing it out. Nice snag there.
Crawford.
Yeah, Michael Crawford making a name for himself.
Let's go,
Craw.
And he got the point. Let's go.
Just hurrying up the offense here.
I like it. Let's go. Let's move, boys. Let's go, Loras. Come on.
Almost designed bubble screen, but he's looking to air it out. Monty Bressner with the catch. He caught that.
Wow. What a catch he caught.
By the freshman.
Yeah.
Pleading
wow.
his case. And this ain't incomplete.
No.
Oh, they said incomplete.
Let's
replay. Oh.
Looks like, I didn't
looks
see
like
it hit
he
the ground.
That
yeah.
ball.
I mean, obviously we have a
different angle.
Yeah, but still.
From this, it looked like it was a clear catch. But hey, if here.
Exactly.
Duhawk switching up here and running the ball. Ty makes the first three guys miss, but then he brought down.
Insane that Ty was not swallowed up immediately in the backfield.
Getting a gain about a yard when it could have been a loss of three.
Kind of surprised Siggy hasn't really targeted Javon yet.
Maybe he put one of their best players on him, too, how good Javon is.
I would imagine.
I was almost kind of surprised they ran the ball this drive so far.
Oh,
right on cue. Yeah. There's Javon. Looks like he went behind the first marker to make a guy miss, but on the first down.
Right on cue, huh?
They're hearing us about it. Speeding up the offense. I like it.
McDevitt out wide.
Sigworth on the move.
No, you got to make that catch there.
The freshman, Monty Brown, with the drop there. Would have been a first down for the Duhawks.
Great play by Sigworth to escape the sack once again. And then sometimes I feel like Siggy just gives up on the pass a little too much and runs right away, but that time the guy's eyes downfield saw the open man, couldn't complete the catch.
Here's using that experience to his advantage. Freshman Monty drop there, that's almost got to be a growing pain you're going to have to go through.
Yeah. Super talented guy, though. You want to
see that. Especially with that complete. I believe on and motion. Hands it to Ty. Ty with a nice gain of balance there. They weren't really expecting the run there, it looked like.
I think Loras is going to score.
That would be a call if you stay here. Jeez, you're the best. Hey, Romo, who?
Look Crawford's way. He's got one on one.
Looks like there's no safety help either. Oh, Monty Brown coming out there. for the pound.
Wow, that play looked doomed from the start.
Looks like that ball was supposed to go to Ty, and Monty just ran across the screen and just snagged it.
I think that might have been by design, though. I think they wanted everyone's eyes to be on Ty, and then
Sigurd took a big hit there, but got it to Monty, who just overpowered the guy.
Ty wasn't even looking for the ball. He was just looking for a block. He came out of nowhere.
He did. Sigworth designed QB run, making a guy miss in the backfield.
Throw it away.
Oh, wow. Keeping it alive. Oh, chucking a guy. Good job by Sigworth there to get a gain of 3, maybe.
The hardest man to tackle of all time. No.
Making plenty of guys miss out there. Did he? Lost a 3 there for the Duos.
I did not think he lost.
Neither did I. Guess it could have been a loss of about 10, though.
Yeah.
So. Sigworth and Eli in the together. He's telling them. Got the 5 wide here. On by Sigworth. Looking for contact, and then got looks like a flag on the play. 2 flags.
Blue flag.
Probably the same call, just both refs.
Yeah.
Own it.
Sean.
On with the hold call. Second 22 player. 28.
That's Shaheen. There.
Sigurd stepping back. It's probably around the most time he's had in the pocket, and he's brought down.
At the 32-yard line. It's going to be pretty hard to pick up this first down now.
Yeah, it is. You just got to get a spot, not enough room for maybe give Farfan a chance to kick it. So a little bit into the wind, so which makes it that for him. And with how big Eau Claire get it up, too.
Yeah. Third and 25.
Monty Brown with the catch. Getting him back to, looks like, around the original line of scrimmage there.
They're going for it. Oh, no, they're kicking their kick. Whoa. They got Talbot.
Yeah, bringing in Zach Talbot.
Touchback Talbot.
Usually the kicker for the Duhawks, but maybe he can get a little higher than Farfan.
Yeah.
Zach's kick is up. No good.
Ooh.
The sophomore Calipari's field goal, no good. That really sucks there.
Huge momentum.
Mm-hmm.
Momentum killer. Really, they've lost a couple guys.
Mm, yeah.
Talbot.
Yeah. But at least Eau Claire's starting around the 20 of their own fields.
Yeah, they have decent starting field position so far. And do our defense anything?
And the defense got a question.
Yeah.
Good job moving. Jonathan gets the snap, hands it off to B-Lot. Bauer. Looks like it's actually the freshman quarterback Harry Rubidox in the game. The blue.
Maybe they're thinking 4 minutes. Maybe this guy's arm.
Pushed out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Second down.
Jay Squinn and Foley in the corner.
Blue gold submission. Handed off to their receiver, who's broke two tackles. Going.
I think everyone was a little confused about where the ball went right
yeah.
there.
Great Trey Furl, the freshman for the Blue Gold.
Carry on the last play by number 8. Ball is spotted.
97, Eli Durton. Gonna break.
He's a big guy.
Every Loras record in the weight room. I think he might have already
done
that.
See him in the weight room all the time is just a man among boys almost.
Yeah.
The Blue rolling out. Look, a little bit of a check down. Drop, pass, a little bit of a ball there. Fourth and three.
Great diving effort right there by Jay.
Yeah. Looks like the freshman could have got something going too. Haven't been moving the ball much.
A great stop there by the Duloc defense.
Yeah. Haven't given up first downs either.
Yeah.
Only gave 4 in the first quarter. Been only a couple.
Yeah.
Tie back to receive the punt. Barnick's punt is up. Nice punt.
Yeah, great punt. Wow.
The Blue Hawks back where they've been on the past two possessions.
We haven't really talked, and he doesn't really get that much credit, especially he's defensive line. 94, Justin Apple. He's on every team's kickoff, and he's hustling hard as fast as guys because he wants it more. He wants to help this team win no matter what it takes. And he's a fifth year, but he's still on and he does not care. He'll do whatever it takes for this Duloc team to win.
He's a player is. A grinder.
Exactly. He's the first one down on every kickoff, even though he's 6'5".
Sigworth and Ty in the backfield. Sigworth dropping back for the pass. Scrambled out by the pressure. Flag on the play, and he just throws it away. Almost has to be a hold here.
Yeah.
Sigworth's pass is incomplete.
Flag down. Talk about it.
That's a rarity, two holding calls on.
Yeah.
Doing really hurting themselves with hurt. Field again. Looks like Eli game. Javon outside. Hand off to Ty.
There we go.
Gets a nice gain there to get closer to the original line of scrimmage here.
Burst through the hole right there. Hit it hard.
Had a pretty good hole there by the whole line opened up. They're going to go with another run here, or you think they're going to go with the pass?
I think you want to kill some clock, but also you want to be aggressive. So
maybe try to draw another pass interference call, maybe.
Yeah.
A little bit of a fake screen.
Oh,
Sigworth
get it,
fall
it, fall it.
Fall on.
93, Jake Sorensen.
Looks like number 51 there, Cave-in. Caught Sigworth there.
Strip sack.
Sigworth had no idea he was there.
Yeah.
Looked like too.
Yeah. We had a perfect advantage.
Yeah.
I'm glad we got
it. Yeah.
That's all.
Because that would have been a guaranteed 3 points.
Yeah.
Blue.
Guys, the deal here. I know you're trying to want to get a good first. There's 2:29 left.
And Blue Goals only have one timeout left as well. So if they burn it there, they don't have any.
And with punts, we have a decent field on this. I'd say.
Yeah. too. Back today too.
Get them back. Mm-hmm.
Weren't there for really bringing in football college atmosphere.
Yeah.
What was much needed.
Not field though.
I've known screen. Back, airing it out to Javon, who knocked down by number three, Ryan Keekley, the freshman.
That was a great play.
Out of Mankato, Minnesota. Looks like the Blue Gold will have around 2 minutes and 20 seconds with one timeout to go down. Try and score. And looks like they'll have field position.
Yeah. This is going to be huge. See if he can get some yards, almost guaranteed to be in field goal range.
Because he's on Duhawg 5, so he's not expecting a whole really long distance punt. Oh.
Just past the
four. Yeah. Quick defense step up here for this final possession of the half. You can bend, but you can't break.
Yeah. A little defensive score here would be nice.
Yeah, that'd be huge going into halftime. Get this crowd going. Been a whole lot to cheer about, really.
Yeah.
Besides the stellar play of the Duhawg defense.
Yeah.
In for Blue Gold. Looks like it's their junior quarterback, Jonathan Log, who keeps it for himself, makes a defender miss, makes a few miss. Oh, no. Brought down by Zakiri. And it looks
great tackle there by Zakiri. Touchdown saver. Had a couple people whiff at first.
And the clock stops. Moves it so. Gives them even more time. Yeah, on that replay there, he just made multiple guys miss, which is a backbreak.
I think they're all so locked. B lot think yeah. About the keeper.
Under center again is for Eau Claire. Sends a motion. Hands it to B lot, making people miss. Hurdles. Close to the first down. Looks like it is. Second and three here with a minute 30 to go for the Blue Gold.
Need this clock to keep on ticking.
Mm-hmm.
Joey Foley now in the game for Zah.
Claire, you almost got to keep running the ball here with how much they've been gaining off of this, but
yeah.
They still got that one timeout.
Yeah, I had to keep running.
The man in. Looks like it's a designed rollout. Oh, they have a man wide direction.
Wow.
Looks like that's their tight end, Joe Swanson.
Great play design to sticking out on the backside. Nobody over there. He was the only one.
Yeah. The senior tight end from Oskaloosa, Wisconsin, Joe Swanson. He was a big guy, too, 6'4". That's always tough and a great defensive left in the half.
Oh, going for
looks
two.
Looks like they're
going for two.
Interesting.
I always wanted Loras to do that and let Farfan get a pass carry. I think
that'd
so
be
awesome.
Nice. And looks like the extra point is up and good. Extra point is good.
For the ball game.
Here's the replay from that play. They set a man in motion and then see there. And just started blocking, just slipped out, and he was wide open, nobody there, and just walked in for the touchdown. Mm-hmm. Almost thought he was going to fall a little bit when he caught it right away.
Great. That's
wishful thinking.
Great play. hopefully we can get something huge. And
maybe
Eli Housebo.
Yeah. It's out here.
Fans halftime is right around. Don't forget about our concession stand on the main concourse. And
looks like number 40, Zach Reyes, for the touch on the special team. He's got a club on his right hand there.
The pride of San Illinois.
Clock's just going to three timeout.
It goes, watching. They're going to
Yeah. Kick is up, and looks like Eli's just going to let it go back into the end zone for a touchback.
Good kick. Yeah. Some quick screens and then
see, probably can hit big.
Yeah. Trick play, even. Remember last year they had that sick trick play.
Yeah,
again,
the
so
little bit of flea flicker and the guy was wide open.
Yeah.
If they don't do that, they could use it to open up the half, too.
Yeah.
Even though the Duhawks will be starting on defense to start the second half.
Just need to get Siggy some time here on these passes.
Yeah. Sigwart's in the pistol formation with Ty next to him. Sends Javon in motion. A little bit of a run to Ty. Just trying to bounce it outside and loses some good amount of yards. Andy went out of the bounds too, so that stops the clock.
Surprised they ran it.
Ty probably should have cut it up there, maybe stay in bounds or something. Unless the game plan was to get out of bounds.
Yeah.
Then.
That might be what Coach H is telling him right now.
Because he probably would have had a gain of like none or a yard if he would have went up the hole. Getting to Eli on a screen pass. Good block by Devon. They're going to call a hold on.
Yucks has been shooting themselves in the foot so far.
Yeah. Guy there.
He seems to as ever come in the that's a killer.
Clock too.
Because now you're thinking about back
and scoring another one.
Yeah.
I almost think they run it. Get the clock going maybe. A little bit of a chunk out of this big deficit in 23. And they do run it. They give by.
Go.
Hits the hole.
Go.
Stays
go.
Up.
Go.
And he
go.
Breaks the tackle.
Go. Timeout.
Hawks move it up to around the 50-yard line. Coach H. Him out.
Great run right there by Eli. Game changing speed.
That is. Gets momentum going. And that's what Eli is. He's that spark plug that can get things going for the. And here's a replay. Missed that one man. And then a good block by his wide receiver, Marty. And then takes three guys.
Great run. Gotta love the Duhawk.
You gotta love it. The athletic workers. Grations that have been up on the scoreboard before. It's just they're doing a good job over here.
Korberg, the new scoreboard, amazing too.
Very beautiful scoreboard. I think it's one of the nicest
D3. Oh, yeah. I think it's top 10 largest. Pretty sure.
Just fits in so well in that hill too.
Another ARC games taken on lacrosse, so they're all in a conference opponent of
then the game is at UT on November 3rd.
It's going to be a fun one. Real shame that couldn't play him last year. They couldn't play
fun game.
Yeah.
Sigworth handed off to Eli, who's brought down immediately. By 2-1, Kaven Blaungen.
Probably before half right here.
Yeah. A little bit of a Hail Mary.
Tuck it deep.
Gonna let it run out to halftime.
Yep.
At the end of the first half, your Loras Duog 0, Eau Claire Blue Golden.
And defensive battle so far.
Hopefully we're going after halftime.
And the only thing that really had Eau Claire going is just because they got the ball so close to their own end zone. Mm-hmm.
So we'll be back to cover the second half after halftime. The start of the half for the Duhawk football game. And so looking at from the first half, the Duhawk actually had more first downs than did. And looking at the had 60 passes, Blue Gold 36. And then the running is actually fairly close. Blue Gold has 82 yards to Loras has 64. So, have to do to make sense here.
Hurting themselves, I feel like they've had plenty of opportunities to take the lead, and they're short. They're just about to grab them, and it slips out of their hands at the last penalty. Get a little bit longer blocks, and I think we'll be good. Mm-hmm. The pass look good and look good. Times look good. Thanks.
As promised at the start of the game, the update on the women's soccer game for Washburn University, who's ranked. It's tied in the second half with around 11 minutes to go, so hopefully we can pull one out. That'd be great for the soccer program.
It'd be a major win. Loras probably be ranked after if they beat.
Yeah, that'd be good. And then looking at the defensive stats, Brett Bauer, top of this list right here.
Yep.
He's got 5 total tackles, and he's got a breakup too. But for Spencer Van Peterson for the Blue Gold has been stirring things up in there. He's got a sack, too.
And another tackle for
3. So that's always a big factor in winning or losing games.
Some pressure on the quarterback, but
he's just been getting ball.
He just gets rid of it before.
And the Duke will be on defense to start this half, so hopefully defense can get a 4-3 and out and then get the offense out there.
Yeah, we'll see if they'll keep running the ball like they did this when they scored. They actually got some movement, unlike the rest of the game.
Yeah. You just got to hope that they made the right adjustments in at halftime and can just pull this one out. That's going to be the first time we'll see Zach actually do a place
off.
Kick.
Live up to his name. Mm-hmm. Back Talbot.
I wonder how close that field goal was that he missed earlier in the first half, too.
I thought he hit it at first, but
the angle.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll go to only a returner back there. Who's a freshman out of Orland Park. Zach is up. Anthony gets it. Got a few blockers. Box miss and he brings it out to around the Blue Gold 22 yard line.
Right there.
Who would you say was the standout player of the first half on the Duhawk defense?
Josh Oglesby, honestly. He got his hand on the ball. And like we said, wasn't for that much, but made four tackles when he wasn't. Yeah. In the way of fools.
Big-time players make big-time plays. You know what they say.
Yep, exactly.
Hopefully we can get some big-time plays here this half, which are much. Oh,
end around.
A little bit of a run.
Forced them out of bounds.
It's not the way you like to see the half start for the Duhawks.
Zach Kempin on the tackle right there.
Nick Kudyk with the run there.
Tackle at the 40-yard line. Result of the play is a first.
Looks like the Blue Gold made some adjustments in there at halftime.
Yeah, I think Joey was supposed to. They're supposed to come back inside, but just got turned.
Mm-hmm. And it looks like they got Jonathan back in there under center for the Blue Gold, and they send a man in motion. Send him back around. Hand off to their work. Oh, flag on the play. Before Austin Belock could even get going.
Gotta be a false start.
Fire snap, false start.
Yep.
Offense, number 63. 5-0.
All right. Defense, I think, would be huge right here.
Big time. Looks like the false star is on their left as well. Confused when they called out his number.
Yeah.
And Ivan Rubel, Clear Lake, Wisconsin, is in the back. And he gets the ball in the handoff. Gets back to around the original line of scrimmage. Looks like it'll be 2nd and 10.
Brett Bauer and that low. Zach Reyes on the tackle.
Big group of substitutions made there by the Blue Gold.
Yeah, they've been making a lot of subs. They have a lot of guys who are rushing
the guys fresh.
Guys. So far,
ended off to another. Oh, and he's Brett Bauer
all over the
flying
place.
Around.
Yeah, is that Brett Bauer, Jamal Adams?
Ivan Rubel ran the ball there as Austin Belock comes back in for him.
Rubel with the carry again on second down.
No replay here as you see Brett Bauer just coming in there and taking them out. Good stop there.
Flying in there a million miles an hour.
3rd and 12 here. The Duhawk here and force a punt. As Austin is in the backfield. Anthony moves in for the field. They throw it. Ball.
Oh,
Joey Foley with
the
interception.
Good pick, Joey. Let's go. Let's go.
That's huge for the Duhawks.
No, there's a flag.
Probably just success celebration, so it's after.
Let's go, Joey. Great play.
That's
he
big.
Made a great play on the ball right there. Oh, wait.
Oh. This isn't. Here's the replay of the interception, folks. You see Joey just jumping out anywhere.
After the play, it's sportsmanlike conduct,
taunting
number 24.
So Joey got with older brother at the taunting.
Doing the talking for him.
Yeah.
I also saw Jack. On that play, he just absolutely ran over the running back, too, when he tried to pick him up for the block. Now the Duhawk offense really needs to get something going here, get momentum back in their favor.
Let's go, Joey. That was a great pick. He broke on the ball perfectly right there.
He had a nice jump.
Yeah.
A little bit of a lurk for all those Madden players out there.
Maybe the big play this Duhawk offense needed to get started.
Almost think they have to go with a shot play here almost after a play like that, man.
Yeah.
A little bit of a designed run, it looks like.
Nothing much.
About to gain a.
Picked a little. That's awesome.
Looks that one, too.
Joey's first career pick.
Many more to come.
Yeah.
Formation, Blue Hawks. Sigworth moves tight right next to him. Fakes the handoff, rolling out. Thrown to Monty Brown.
Great pass.
He catches it pretty close to the sticks.
Sigworth's pass is caught by number
Great
eight.
Pass.
They're giving the first down. That was a nice pass.
Yeah. Even though he stood in there and took the hit, too.
Glad to see he hasn't wavered away from throwing it to Monty after that couple drops.
Yep. He's been a big play after that.
Good to see those freshmen always bouncing back after a play. Sigworth gets the snap. Looking for somewhere to, and he just throws it away. There's nowhere to go.
Yeah,
that looks like he's looking for a shovel pass to the big tight end, Mike McDevitt.
Well, Claire was waiting for it.
At first, I thought triple option, like fake shovel pass. It wasn't there then.
Gonna hit us a play that player scored on where everything's going that way. Then he turns and looks back the other way.
For a trick, honestly, that would be.
Yeah.
Things off.
There's no intentional grounding or backward pass.
I think Oakley intentional grounding.
Got Eli anti. Now. Mike McDevitt, Monty Brown, and Marty McGovern all the way. The outside top of your screen. Ty goes out wide.
The five wide.
Sigworth giving it to Ty over the middle. Good job by Ty to hold on to that before after taking the hit.
See, that's the plays. If we can just get those small chunk plays repeatedly, that's what he needs is one first down. A penalty and then a negative yard run, and then you're facing 3rd and 15, you know?
Mm-hmm. Off to Ty. Oh, who spins off a guy?
Go!
Got a man to beat.
Go!
Knocked out of bounds there, but he gets the first down, and they're on the Eau Claire. Looks like the Eau Claire 12 is where the line judge is lining us up at.
Great run right there. Ty's spin move, as we've seen today, has been deadly.
And you can see here on the replay, when he gets the handoff, he just hits the hole and makes the first guy miss with the spin move and then makes the big D lineman miss with just a burst of speed.
Yeah, too fast.
Mm-hmm. Sigworth, a bit of a design run option, bouncing it around and looks like a gain of nothing.
Looks like he's pleading with his old line right there to give him a block.
Sigworth with the keeper.
Keeper there.
I want to get Ty back in the game. Oh, is that Jack Foley up there enough? Oh, no. That was crazy. I was going to say, I thought Jack Foley was lining up at wide receiver for a second. Couldn't
be
my eyes.
Something.
Yeah.
Sigworth in the pocket. Hitting Eli over the middle on the angle route. And. Oh,
down
first
and
goal. Oh, ooh. Looks like another player
Sigworth's
hurt.
Pass is complete to number 16.
That was a great catch right
that
there.
That was. In contact.
Ball is spotted at the 1 yard line. First and goal.
Dang, too many injuries today.
Yeah.
Hopefully, be able to walk up off his own power.
I'm not going to show the replay of the injury because it was pretty bad. So that's why we haven't shown a replay of that.
But he was able to get up.
And that's
walk
always
off,
good.
So that is all that matters.
Mm-hmm.
First and goal here for the Deluxe. Let's go.
Got Siggy and Ty in the backfield.
I almost imagine this ball has to be going into Ty.
That's what I was thinking. Line scrimmage is a bit of a fake or something here. Give it to Eli, maybe. They hand it to Eli, who is... What are the rest? Those are going to clear off the dog
calm
pile.
Down.
And yeah. Not a touchdown.
Right in the back.
Maybe try QB sneak Thomas here at some point, too, maybe.
Second and goal.
Siggy and Ty.
Oh no! Oh.
There's the flag. Uh-oh. Siggy's a little beaten up. That was a pretty...
Yeah, that did not...
Yeah. Almost looked like hit that.
That could have been the absolute worst case scenario if Siggy got hurt and Eau Claire got the ball.
What do they call it? So.
Come on. That's can't have that. You're on punching into the game and you get a start. You almost get you killed in the process.
Touchdown. Little
I think a late hit right here.
Screen pass out to Eli was no good. Thrown over his head by Sigworth.
Those penalty yards right back.
Hopefully.
Got it.
Sigworth pointers down.
Yep.
Huge bucks.
Exactly what they needed. Fans love it.
Mm-hmm. This is causing a problem for my papers.
Blowing them all over. Quarterback power. Get
Sigworth. And he's in there for the touchdown.
Let's
yes,
go.
Sir. That's a huge score for the Dewhawks.
Sir, Siggy letting Eau Claire know, too.
Who else but the captain of this offense, Noah Sigworth.
Yep.
Hopefully Farfan doesn't get blocked on the AT here.
He's got it.
Sigworth. Pitch it.
Oh. Yeah, first one is forward lateral.
Sigworth's running him out of bounds here. Oh, he's letting him know about it, too. Starting to get a little chippy out here.
Yeah.
Here's a replay of Sigworth's run as well. As you see, he just burrows through all those guys and just runs it in there.
I like that play call. Get the ball in your best player's hands.
He's letting him know about it, too, after that touchdown as well.
Game trying to get a little chippy here.
Mm-hmm, it is. Play, he ran Dick Martin. Oh, here's the call.
Happens block, try. An illegal forward pass. The try is no good.
After that, Siggy ran Vic Martinelli and has had a few words for him after that, too.
The sideline started getting a little chippy there. So, a blocked field goal, a missed field goal, and a blocked extra point so far for the Dewhawks. Kind of reminds me of the Cowboys-Buccaneers game.
Yeah.
Cowboys in that game. Kicker missed two field goals and an extra point.
Yeah. That was a great game to start the NFL season off, though.
That was a really good game. Just like this one's great game to start the
Dewhawk football season.
Again, the 50-50 ticket, the winning number is 404.
Talbot gets ready for the kickoff here.
If you have that number, please report to the
hopefully we can see a touchback here.
Yeah. That looked pretty good. Gotta give him some credit there.
Made some halftime adjustments, much needed, and hopefully defense can force another turnover here. Nothing like some Oz. The boys got
song.
Talbot takes him into the zone. And he's brought down around zone.
Good kick. Looks like
kick for Loras. Returned by
he's right.
Never
mind.
He's limping off the field, maybe. Looks like. Maybe just a cramp.
Some Dustin Harris. His sophomore year, then transfer Central. I'm playing safety, used to be a corner.
Looks like it's Austin. B-load is the running back in the backfield for the blue gold.
Give it to him.
He is stood up at the line. Job by the Duhawk defensive line to really clog those running holes.
Mm-hmm.
Number five, Austin Bila.
Another Joey Foley pick, perhaps?
Second and ten.
That would be something.
Yeah.
So it looks like Jonathan Alug is still the quarterback for the Blue Gold. And it looks like they got the freshman in the backfield for the Blue Gold, Ivan Rubel. Back in. Play action. Oh, he's got a man wide on the field.
He dropped it.
Thank goodness.
Oh, that was Zach Kemp.
Zach Kemp got burnt.
Yeah.
I just saw him run the post. I was like, oh, no.
We need some pressure. He didn't have all day to pass.
Yeah.
Yeah, wow. Can't, a huge drop right there.
Got Josh Oglesby on that front four right now. I see him out there. Hopefully he can make a play here.
The playmaker, the bright yellow shoes, too.
Easy to see. Makes our life easy.
Yep. He's a big Steelers fan, too, so I think that might be part of the decision for the...
Oh, understandable. Yep. Same colors.
Yep.
As the blue gold man in motion here on the 10.
Boom! Big hit! Let's go!
And he's letting them know about
Let's
it, too. That's possibly one of the biggest hits I've seen in person.
From the corner, too. He only weighs 200 pounds, but he's laying
the boom. He lined that up, too.
Hit stick.
That was a...
Joey Foley. Yes, sir.
That was a nice hit by Joey.
That's my best friend. Let's go.
Roommate?
Next year.
Oh, okay.
And last year.
Okay.
Forced the punt. Let's go. Back-to-back great defensive drives.
Defense is
I think we're
nice.
Getting some energy back. We're getting some back. The offense. You saw Siggy was fired up. I'm fired up. Everyone's fired up. Let's go.
The blue gold punt here. Pretty decent punt. Takes a little bit of a blue gold bounce, and Duhawk's going to be running back out there on offense, looking to continue the momentum they've got here. If they score here, I think they're going to go for two.
I think you have to.
I mean, the field goal and the extra point have been blocked.
The kicking game's struggled so far, so.
I think it's just so hard for Farfan because he's not the tallest guy, and then he's going up against those big guys from Eau Claire.
Yeah. Automatic, or he's pretty automatic. Just even getting a good for Josh conversation. I think the blocking scheme, so.
Looks like the rest are talking about something.
Interesting. That's it.
I was like, a lineman's getting picked up again.
Yeah, maybe the race or something.
BJ, well, we got this downtime for the outcome of all season.
Said, surprise coaches. I think they're going to be a, I think they're going to be a conference. You know, they're popping in budget. I think this year's might be even higher, and I think they have a high. So teams are going to be tough. But everything else, I think Loras has, they have no reason why they shouldn't expect to win. Yeah. UD, that's going to be a very exciting game back.
Crosstown, right?
Always close, no matter what the game you expect. It's going to happen. The game's always been crazy.
Yeah.
So I would say Duloc's probably going to go, let's see.
Going to shock some people.
I'd say three losses.
The Loras soccer game is in overtime right now against Wash U, so hopefully they're able to pull that one out in overtime. Overtime is always, always exciting.
What exciting game.
Duhawks have came to play, stopping the no points so far through regular.
You'd have to think that'd crack them in the top 20.
Yeah.
Even just going to overtime in this team.
Yeah. Second and nine here, as Sigworth's all alone in the back. And out. Sigworth is hit as he throws. In between Hunter Machi and Marty McGovern.
Almost had it, almost connected.
Maybe if he didn't get hit there when he threw it, he might have had him.
Yeah, look, if he could have put a little more juice on it.
Yeah. Big third down here for the Duhawks. Siggy waiting to get the calls in from the side. Devon and he has no time in the pocket, but he airs it out. Throws his man. I believe that was Marty McGovern again.
Pretty decent coverage there. Man,
it was. No time again.
Man, nothing working there.
Mm-mm. Farfan, hold of this punt right here.
Let one rip, Farfan.
Pretty decent punt.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh!
No, don't roll it. Get it.
No.
Oh! Let's go!
Great defensive effort there by special teams.
I think that was Mason
I think
Morris.
It was too.
Let's go!
That's great hustle.
What a punt. No, there's an end. Dang.
That's tough. Well, we can get a look right here on the replay. Oh.
It went over, but it didn't
hit the ground.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a close call.
Well, that was a good punt. So.
Yeah. Here's another look here. I don't think it hit the line.
Yeah, I don't think it did.
It's always a tough call, though.
Yeah, that's a great hustle.
It was.
He came out of nowhere to go.
Yeah, I didn't think they had a chance. Yeah. Just see purple jerseys running down there as the blue gold man's wide open, and he breaks a tackle, and he's brought down after the sticks. Tackled by Dawson and Charlie, the junior out of Janesville.
Number 85, Isaac Garside.
A lot of the intermediate, like little curl routes, have been open for all players so far.
You used to play for these guys. Are they a lot of a zone or more man-type defense?
They switch it up. I'd say pretty good amount of both, but I'd say probably more zone. It also depends on the team, too, you know.
as the Blue Gold send a man in motion. They hand it to him. Oh, missed tackle. Another missed tackle.
Lost Charlie again.
Mm-hmm. I believe that was Marcus Lampley who missed right after he got it.
He's about to tackle him as he's handing the ball off at first.
And just missed him. That would have been a huge stop there.
Eau Claire has done a really good job at misdirection and never revealing who actually has the ball.
And then the Duhawks kind of struggling with the tackles a little bit too, right at the line of scrimmage. Eau Claire sends a man in motion. From the shotgun, he gets his tight end Joe Swanson for the first down. And those curl wrestles have been open every single play that they run them.
These quick hitters.
What would the adjustment be for that?
Well, I would say, you know, try to out this into, but then we also have gotten beat. So if you start doing it, easier.
Sounds like it's a little correction.
Yeah, I think they're just reading the scouting report.
A lot of people here on the line of scrimmage for the Blue Gold. They send a man in motion. Hand it off. Good stop there by the Duhawks to allow him to little to no gain there.
Brett Bauer.
Everywhere. He's everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Rushing attempts. Number 8.
Kind of feel like Eau Claire should go back to B-Lock a little bit.
He hasn't really ran the ball a whole lot this quarter.
Yeah, done a decent job stopping him, but like that's like riding him.
Yeah. And he was there. A play fake. He's got a man wide open.
Oh, no.
And he catches it. Dang. And he's brought down by, I believe that was Josh Rydberg, maybe?
Yep, it was. Throw there. Lofted up in the air. Allowed his guy to run under.
Killer there for the Duhawks.
Yeah. They're tied having a day so far.
As you see the play action, just sucked the Duhawks into it. Quarterback just aired it out to his man. Tough.
Oh, here's O-line. Mm-hmm. The running backs have done a good job picking up all the blitzes that the Duhawks have brought today.
Duhawks are just so keyed in on B-Lot that any play action, they're going to go after him.
Exactly.
It looks like it's B-Lot and Rubel formation there for the Blue Gold. So they hand it to B-Lot, who's brought down after about a 4-yard gain.
All right, come on, Loras, dig in here.
Rushing attempt, number 5.
How's Joey? Oh, he's getting looked at a trainer. Mm-hmm. That's not on the field.
I didn't notice that until you now.
His back-to-back possessions, he had the pick and then the big hit.
Yeah. Hopefully he's able to get back out there soon. A key part of the Duhawks.
Yeah.
Blue Gold move guys over in motion. They hand it to B-Lot, who's hit fairly close around the line of scrimmage.
Nothing there.
He's just really had nowhere on all game.
Four down territory. He goes down, that's huge. You get a touchdown, I'd say you're probably sitting good with how your defense has been playing against this Loras offense.
As a loud here. Huge third down here.
Coming down shotgun.
I believe the running back, Rubel, in the back. Screen, little curl, first down.
Quarterback's impressive. Go right there.
The West Coast offense. Quick. Let's get it out of it.
The receiver's bully rolling. He could catch it fully with the diving effort. It wasn't enough.
Joey's getting his helmet back on, ready to go out there.
I think it might have been a shoulder pad issue with him.
Got the... Looks like he's all backfield.
Oh, wow.
Oh, there. Looks like it's like formation here. Oh, and he rocked it. Open field tackle.
Good play by
nice
Mac.
Nice open field tackle there.
Brett McWilliams.
Looks like a Duhawk is hurt down there. Oh.
I did not see who that was for the Duhawks.
I didn't see who it was either.
Sam Jones. Yeah, it is Sam Jones.
A huge factor to this Duhawk defense.
Yeah.
Game the second time just started for the Loras women, and it's still zero, and they need a goal, and they need to get a goal here for the win, which would be huge. Like we said multiple times, this is a huge game for the soccer team here, would almost guarantee a the AA.
Still down. He's moving his leg though.
Mm-hmm. There's been a lot of injuries so far in today's game for both sides, and it's always just sad. Especially with Sam Jones being a senior too.
Yeah, one of the anchors of mm-hmm. his defense and his defensive line. Made a lot of big plays today so far. They do have the stretcher back.
Like, Loras trainer's motioning for it. And they're bringing the stretcher out now.
Oh, no. Oh, it's not Sam. I think that's a Wellborn. Oh, jeez. Two players stretch it off, one get it off, yeah. Never good. He is moving though, so that's.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he's gonna get up.
He sat up.
I think that might be Chance Haffill.
Yeah.
Yep.
The senior from Cedar Rapids, Iowa.
Also a fifth year. Looks like they're doing something to his foot. I mm-hmm. have to imagine it's like an ankle or
yeah.
something like that.
Almost looks like they're putting on a air cast.
Yeah. Ah, man.
Coach Elminiak giving them some words of encouragement there.
So Duhawks take a knee on the sideline.
Mm-hmm. That isn't his football career. Yeah. Looks like it's his right leg or ankle.
Yeah. Joey fully subs back in now.
Looking to make a big play on defense.
Shout out to the training staff, though. They've had a busy day, and they've been on top of it.
Yeah, they've been doing good so far for both teams, too.
Yep, Chris Cram's a great trainer. Take chance off the field now.
Duhawks need a big stop here. That front seven really has to push there.
Pins back here.
They got two wide receivers out wide as they mow over. Looks like they hand it off to him. And then running in for the touchdown.
Too easy.
Yeah. Zach Kemp was the one who tackled him. It was a little too late.
I've liked the Eau Claire's play calls on the goal line so far. I've had a couple nice ones.
But on the bright side, Duhawks are only down by touchdown. Let's see.
They do this every emotion, just wasting our time. They're not actually going.
He walks down by eight. And here's the replay of the motion here. Zach Kemp just a little too late over.
Yeah, 2-on-2 blocking, and then the safety is a little too late, and guy on the edge fell for the other handoff. So
Nick Kudick, the one who scored that, more out of Austin, Wisconsin.
What do you know about Wisconsin?
Austin, Wisconsin starts with an M. That's about it.
Kudick's from
there. Yeah. You know
him. Yeah, there's nothing that we haven't already said.
Looking at this roster, there's a lot of towns that I've never really heard of from. And there's just noticed all these from Minnesota and Wisconsin. Illinois players. I see that Wisconsin. Yeah,
I think
that's got to be the scenery coming up. Florida getting here in January, yeah. Winter hit.
Like snow before, you know.
A little bit of a.
Oh no. Smart kick at the guy who has a club. Yeah.
Eli kind of took a hit there after the whistle, too.
Yeah.
Looks like Duhawks are going to have to go the length of the field almost to get a score here.
I thought this was going to try that first, but one of the speedsters pick it up.
Mm-hmm. Almost saw for a second there they weren't going to. Almost saw it. Second.
Heart dropped a little.
In the backfield. Hands it off to Ty, who's stopped scrimmaging back.
I think the Loras offense try to get Siggy going here. Try to give him a base, maybe quarterback run, or just like a bootleg, something.
Yeah, something that just...
He's made all the... Mm-hmm. So.
Get the crowd going. Ooh, Javon Williams hit hard there.
Right as he caught it.
By Ryan Kuechly. Yeah. He's been around the ball a lot today.
Yeah. A name like Kuechly, you think he's going to make a lot of tackles.
Mm-hmm. And he's a big, good size for safety. 294. And he's only a...
Wow. Cool freshman.
Playing for these guys. Backfield to five wide. Looking for Ty out, and he's got...
Get up the field.
Ty's got base.
There we go.
Looks like he got the first down. Nice play there for the Duhawks to get something going.
Way to move chains.
With 39 seconds left to go here in the third. Four here before the end of the quarter would be huge.
Yeah. They should look deep again. They haven't really looked deep so far.
Hit him with play.
Yeah.
They wouldn't see it coming. Especially the wind's really... Seems like there's...
Oh, where are you?
It's a killer.
Yeah, like... Another perfect pull. Shooting us a little too much.
If we can't bounce back from this, we know what to talk to be about at the end.
In the ball game, this team is a good team. Yeah. We're right there with them, despite our
mental mistakes and all that stuff.
Keep setting ourselves back, but we're still right
there. Yeah. I mean, we're playing.
Oh.
Got one there.
Took a big hit.
Shook it up.
Dang, Siggy's one tough guy, man. Yeah, he took a hit right there.
Beat up a lot this game, I've noticed. He's getting up. I remember in the first half when he got hit, it took him a while to get up.
Yeah. Hand and okay,
you won the D1 transfer Devin Moore. I think Siggy's let him come out.
There's no way Siggy's not going back out there.
Nice punt there by far. Yeah,
make him back up a lot.
Missing the tackles there. Nice hit there by the Duhawk. Kind of stared down at him after two. I believe that was Brett McWilliams on the tackle.
Yeah.
34, Shaq, tackled
at the 41-yard line. First blue goal. South sideline for Duhawk. It's kind of like warpy and almost kind of concerning. I think when you see him up right now.
Yeah. As a Duhawk offensive lineman gets treated on the sideline, the blue gold Duhawk tackle missed two tackles. Blue gold's brought down out of bounds. Close here gets the left guard for the Duhawks, Mitchell Huizinga, who's getting treated. And then at the end, Loras Duhawks, Eau Claire Blue Gold's 14.
Surprised they passed the ball right there. I thought this quarter you're probably just going to see handoff after handoff after handoff.
Really drain that clock out.
Yeah. Quick hitters they've had in their pocket. They've been retimed this little five and out.
Yeah, the only
curls.
Uncompleted passes are those deep ones, 15, 20 plus yards down the field.
Linebacker.
Because the Foley bros, they know they don't want to.
Yeah,
they saw
what happened when you throw them.
goal scoring a women's soccer game. It ended in double overtime, 0-0. The next game is at Funtbone in St. Louis.
What a game. That must have been an electric game to be it. And the next, a very big event, another rank in the top fives.
Work cut out.
Like a top tier schedule.
Yeah. And we know that our women's side, they're legit.
Yeah, they're not going in double overtime with that team. And then if they can come out with a win next week or another double overtime, like they're going to be, there's no way they're not going
to
be ranked.
Yeah. They're a team that'd be hard to come into the Rock Bowl and face. Yeah. Or anywhere, really.
Yeah.
It's fourth quarter. More here.
I've been kind of quietly in this second. About dead time, you know, not, nothing much for them to get excited about, though. Another pass.
A roll out here. As the quarterback takes his loss and runs out of bounds here.
Yeah, like a yard?
Yeah, I think so, if that. Oh, we got a few yards, it looks. Looks like it's 3rd and inches here, maybe.
Gave him the
first down.
It was pretty. The sticks there. Yeah. You know? I mean, he got it. Belt backfield. B-Lock gets it and he gets gained about 4 yards there before he swarmed around the Duhawks.
Oh no, oh he's up. Maybe. Alright, thank God. I thought we were about to have another injury right there as Eau Claire offensive lineman is laying on the ground a little.
Yeah, like B-Lot only had like 6 yards rushing. So, I mean, the D's really been keeping him under wraps. As Google get the snap. Errant throw there on the quarterback, but as well.
Pass incomplete receiver.
So, kind of the Eau Claire's throwing the ball as much.
Yeah. Maybe they're tired of trying to get something. Who knows?
To be fair, Duhawks have done a pretty good job against him.
Only has 44 rushing yards so far in this game. I mean, playing the Duhawks defense has been amazing. I mean, they've been out on the field for 23 minutes this game too, so they've been working.
Now they give it to him.
B-Lock, it's the first down there and gets the chains rolling.
Carries to number 5, Austin B-Lot. Result of the first down for the Blue Golds.
Looked like Eli Dirch just came in for the Duhawks.
Yeah.
Sam came out. Josh Oglesby, my apologies, came out.
Gotta get the pressure here.
Mm-hmm.
Passages.
Maybe
something.
Not there on the side of the field. Might just go a little bit ground. As they hand it to Rubel, who's hit the line of scrimmage for little to no gain.
There you go. Come on, Duhawks. We're seeing defensive line changes almost every play.
Maybe we're trying to keep them fresh in this heat, keeping them hydrated and all that.
Also shows you how deep this defensive line's been, long been a strength for Loras.
Yeah.
2019, they were in that whole nation.
I mean, you just love to hear that.
Yeah.
As the Blue Gold sent a couple guys in motion. out of the shotgun, hands off to B-Lot. B-Lot's got a hole, makes a couple guys miss, and he's going to take this one all the way to the house. That's a backbreaker for the Duhawks.
Huge hole right there. Mm-hmm. A couple guys trying to come and make a dive and tackle, just couldn't make it.
In order for the Duhawks to come back in this one, they're going to need a score, and almost a defensive turnover.
Yeah.
And then they'll have to score right away. With point in there.
Yeah. Couldn't they just score two times?
What if it's a trick play now?
Yep.
So that puts Eau Claire blue gold at 26. Duhawks really need a spark here. Then here's the replay of just the hole he had and a couple missed tackles by the Duhawks and almost just walked into the end zone, really.
Best run he's had so far today.
It is. It's probably the time they need it the most, really.
Yeah. Do you base again or what they're going to do?
Yeah. Adam. Bounds.
Oh, he was on the sideline now. Might put some in for him. That's what seems like Coach Bauer's talking about. It appears they are.
Probably a smart decision out there.
What if they kick it at Sam Jones? He takes it to the
house. Takes it to the house. Per usual. Of Apple. The pooch kick.
Justin Apple wanted to catch that punt so bad, or that kickoff so bad.
It's a shame if Fair caught that. Ty kind of had some room to work there.
Yeah. Oh, some Eau Claire players getting into it with the Duhawks.
Some of the Duhawks are a little confused on what was happening,
yeah.
I think.
I think everyone's a little confused.
First and 10 for the Duhawks on their yard line. Gonna have to have a fairly quick 80-yard drive here if they want to keep their hopes alive.
I would imagine they're probably gonna go hurry up offense, no huddle right here.
A lot of passes, too, I'd assume. Maybe on the same page.
Yeah. And also,
he was pressured.
He released the ball almost right away, too. Mm-hmm. Kind of insane that he pressed that fast.
Michael has been, he's been getting a lot of time.
Lots.
Play action.
There we go, Craw.
Flag on flag. The play, though.
Pass is caught by Crawford. There is a penalty marker down.
I don't know what it could be, though.
I think that might be an illegal man downfield. I think one of the linemen might have been running a little too early.
Here's a replay.
Yeah, you can see that replay. Good catch and throw by Crawford, though.
Was it Big Sean?
No.
Man downfield, offense, number 63.
That would be... Okay, I was going to say, I have a 63.
Then Eli Denton. I was going to say, I was like, I don't see a 63 on her sheet.
Another example right here.
Yeah.
One step forward, two steps back. Yeah.
That seemed to be the thing for the DuHawks almost last year, as the one game we saw. Yeah. Even though they did win pretty handily, as Sigworth has room to run.
What a run.
Good run by, and there's another flag on the play.
I really hope it's cold.
I hope so too, but I almost
did this one. Yeah, I just saw him do the motion. And you can see the Duhawk offense going backwards.
Yeah.
Mike McDevitt.
Duhawks work on this practice.
Any penalty?
Happy no, about all.
Not at all.
Brown came back for Crosby. Going in to win this drive a little bit here.
Get some momentum going.
Sigworth looking to air it out. Airs it out to double coverage. And he's picked. The Blue Gold running it back. Sean stripped him out of bounds, but it doesn't matter. Blue Gold takes possession. Interception by Carmelo Rosado.
The way he's going, you have to think. Let's wraps it up.
The Blue Gold just ran the ball last season too. Play of Sigurd really just forced it.
Yeah.
Right when he left, we saw that. Like we.
Monty was even. Kind of off, yeah.
Playing pretty come up to then as well, so.
Yeah.
Blue Gold send a man in motion, they hand it up. It gets brought down by a DuHawk.
Charlie Dawson.
Good job there by DuHawk to stop that. That run by Nick Kudick.
Carry by number 18. 6 yard line, second down.
David Anthony back in the game for the Blue Gold, big hit from Jolly earlier in the game.
Surprised back after that big
moment too. So that's kind of a college football moment too.
A ring ring moment.
Mm-hmm. Austin Belot's got a hole. Made a couple guys miss. Almost looked like a hole there on the number 11 wide receiver, Alex Kaminsky, but they don't call it.
And, Austin Belot. Mitchell Hasenga's taken all his pads off, so that's never a good sign.
Yeah, we saw him over there between the third and the fourth quarter, getting work down there with the trainers. And two due to COVID, so.
That's a
haven't really had
tough,
him for,
tough stretch for this Loras offense. Just can't get healthy.
I had non-experienced players out there now.
Yeah.
Malik hands it off to Rubel in the field, who makes a guy miss and gets it out for about a gain of 7 yards.
Mentioned in the first half, this running kind of seemed to starting to run. Source defense. We're starting to see a lot more missed tackles than we saw in the first half, and they're pushing the ball a lot more than they were before.
Yeah. I mean, especially with their big back. I mean, 5'11", 5'11", 190, and 211. I mean, those are all people.
Yeah.
And that offensive line, I mean, they're all just.
Yeah. And they've been on the
for
all
a long
game,
time,
yeah. Good job by Blaine right there. Set the edge, force him back inside.
David Anthony up carry on that one. As substitutions for DuHawk defensive line come in.
Attack with the 15, result for the play is a first down.
So you're pretty big group substitution. for the Blue Gold as Belot comes back into the game.
The Stuhawk defense, got to give it to them. They've been out there a lot.
They've been busting their tail.
Yeah.
Blue Gold sends the guy in motion. And he gets a snap, looking to air it out here. Hits his check down, makes the guy miss.
Wow.
Feet. That was a nice play there by their wide receiver.
I don't understand why he passed it there, though. I'd just run every single play. Clock. Don't risk an interception.
Yeah, they probably just want to get extra score in here. Then.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, this Duhawk defense, seeing a lot of hands on hips here. And as you see, he just takes a 3-step drop, hit hand on the check down, been wide open all game. Spin move, make a couple guys miss an extra yard.
Alright, come on. Let's get a push here.
Action.
Wide open.
And he just falls into the end zone.
2-on-1 right there. Nothing really Dawson Charlie could do there.
Yeah. Trey Fitzgerald with the catch there. And he's listed as a quarterback on their depth chart.
Huh. He was not a quarterback, honestly.
He's a do it all type of quarterback.
Taysom Hill, I guess.
Start off promising. Is up and good.
Extra point is good.
As the quarterback sent the guy in motion, then all the Duhawks bid on the play fake, and then Trey Fitzgerald's wide open there.
If they had Larry Fitzgerald, they'd be passing the ball every. Looked like the other guy was open in the back of the zone.
Just bit on the. Seems like. Which is just a show of respect they have for. Yeah. All right, make their.
Take your poison.
Do you want someone to.
Siggy played a great. Keep riding on that. You gotta keep riding.
He's in the line.
And off outcome too, you know. So the guys
hurt. It looks like Mitchell's he's got back on. Another pooch kick. Good hands out there by Sam Jones, I believe.
Yeah. All around athlete.
Oh yeah. So, in your opinion, how have the players watch been doing in today's game?
Sam, he's been pretty good. We haven't called his name too much, but he's getting double, triple teamed a lot. You know, it's hard to see what's going down there. Jack Foley, they threw it to, I can only remember one time where he made that perfect throw where they got it in. And Siggy, I've been, Lord, he's had to do his, lost 20, come on, did that 4 or 5.
Out. And put a little too much on that one. He took another hit that play.
Yeah.
It's almost every time he's passed, hit.
He let that one rip, though. That was, that was a good throw.
He's going to be feeling sort of.
Emulous?
He's.
Good to see. Injury stuff.
Oh, right on cue. There he is.
There you go,
first down. pushing it out to around the 42-yard line.
Yeah, Dwayne's a really good ball player.
Pass complete to number one, Dwayne Emelis. Results of the play for Loras College, first down.
I just hear just a quick slant route, and he hit it for the first down.
Oh no, Sigworth.
Sigworth fumbled the snap. And there's a pile here. Sigworth fell on it.
Yeah. Oh, thankfully. Just dropped the snap right there.
I also just noticed Drake Sorensen on the sideline here. The right tackle for the Duhawks.
Okay, as well.
Worth hitting Dwayne again. Who's back to around the original line of scrimmage before he's brought down.
Pass is caught by number one, Dwayne Emelis.
There you go, Dwayne.
Third down.
The two receivers out wide for Duhawks, Crawford and McGovern, both. Trick High School.
Oh. A breeding ground for Duhawk football players, football wide receivers. For
super old, high school. 1860 or something.
Gosh. Yeah. Sigworth steps back. Hit as he throws. Little high pass. Sigworth is
a
little slow to get
out. I would think about taking Siggy out just so he doesn't get hurt.
See what Devin Moore can do, man.
I mean, why not?
State play transferred to South Dakota State. Now he's here. I mean, why not see him?
Yeah.
Farfan, the punter. Gets the punt up and...
Oh!
It's a hop in the favor of the Blue Golds.
Yeah, that's a tough hop.
I think another thing to work on in practice this week would probably be special teams, punting and kicking probably.
Yeah, special teams kind of struggle. Kickoff. But we only saw them twice, so.
Yeah. A little bit of a feel for them.
Now, Claire's special teams, on the other hand, let's say it's extremely good. Like, all the punts they had, they were right on time. Nowhere on.
Looks like Gwynn's in at Kier in the bottom of your screen for the Duhawks. As Blue Gold send a in motion. They hand it to B-Lot, who tried to hurdle over somebody but didn't really work out for him.
McGovern's getting some treatment on the sideline, too.
Looks like his shoulder.
Yeah.
Carry by number five, Austin B-Lot. The 38 second down.
I wonder how they're going to get in there and, Maligan there for the Blue Golds?
Yeah, I'm surprised. The younger guys, we haven't really seen as much.
Looks like Devin Moore's warming up on the sideline for for the Duhawks.
Smart.
Oh, Lott's got a hole, and he just puts his shoulder down and just runs over the Loras defender.
Lead D3 in rushing all year.
Yeah.
He's probably got to be around what? He's at 44.
He's got to be close to 80.
Yeah, he's probably around 80. Yeah.
Just ran over the Loras defender there for the first down.
I mean, so he's already almost at like 500 rushing yards through two games. Yeah.
I'm actually kind of looking forward to seeing Devin Moore. See what he can do.
See what he has.
The lefty quarterback. Not traditional these days.
Mm-mm, not at all.
Rubel just kind of stumbling, bumbling through all those guys.
Rumbling, stumbling.
I'm
trying to think. Is Tua the only lefty quarterback?
I think he is.
Yeah. I'll checking in for the first time for the... Fuck, former time.
former tight end moved D line. Can't be an easy transition. Mm-hmm.
Think you might have high school running back in high school.
Handed off to B-Lot, making a couple plays. Flag on the play, almost has to be a hold.
Yeah.
Eli's helmet came off.
Yep.
7-2, that's their center, Riley Bohr, the freshman out of Eau Claire, Wisconsin.
Come on, we got to get a stop here. We want the lefty, come on.
Yeah, we want to see Devin.
He's a big guy, too.
25.
That's like Cam Newton. Cam Newton might weigh a little more.
Yeah. More muscular. QB keeper. Got nowhere to go. Good job there by Jack Foley to make the stop.
Player to watch, Jack Foley.
We really only called that play and then the tackle he made earlier.
Yeah. Jack's tackling corners. I mean, never afraid. Like, you know, sometimes corners, you know, they're usually more sleight of frame. They're afraid to, like, stick their nose in there.
Yeah.
Not Jack. Bronx, dude.
Yeah. Third for the Duo. Maybe get a stop here. See that quarterback.
Mm-hmm. And positively, you know, it's the end of something.
Yeah. Eau Claire hands it off. Stopped after a gain of around 3 yards. Looks like we're going to see Devin Moore probably.
With the rushing attempt.
Let's go.
43-yard line.
I remember last year when there's rumors of him coming here, that's just the talk around campus.
Yeah.
It's him coming here. The kick it up and then looks like back there. Miss and on the 32. Oh boy, here we go. Moore's for the Duhawk coming up right here.
He wait going for it.
I'm excited to see this. Let him throw it. Might just be a couple runs here.
You got Dwayne.
He just got such a good the line. Devin gets snapped, drops back. Looking to air out, gets as McDevitt's looking for a flag there. Threw it into almost like triple coverage there. Like
freshman Jamel Britt.
By number Von Moore. Incomplete intended for number 13, Mike McDevitt.
Kind of Sean, they kept. I'm kind of surprised they kept Sean in the game there. Maybe because they're running low on linemen.
Yeah, I just don't know who else they would put in, probably.
Yeah.
They might start moving the center D line.
Yeah. Devin airing it out.
Oh.
Almost caught there by the Duhawks.
Harrison Willis.
A junior out of Western Springs, Illinois.
Harrison Willis.
As McDevitt comes out of the game for the Duhawks and Machichs in. 1:43 here left to play in the game. They just hand it off to their freshman running back who gets the first down for the Duhawks.
Good run.
Jamal Britt, the freshman out of Chicago.
Kids on this team, too.
There is. It's Devin Roll.
So far, on target.
Looking for wide receiver number 80, Jamal Haynes, the sophomore. The sophomore of Florida. Gets a little bit of a low snap, so they hand it off to Jamal.
Go!
Through, kids.
There you go.
Okay, Jamal.
Don't stop! Let's go.
A big run there by Jamal.
Yeah, nice run. Please tell me no one's hurt. Thank goodness.
On the handoff, you can see the bad snap, and Jamal just hits the guy at the stiff arm and just keeps running. I believe that was Spencer Van Peterson on the stiff arm, too. As Devin rolls out, throwing it.
Oh,
nice play. As he stays up for the catch. Nice play there by Devin. Across the body, since he's a lefty, too, to Hunter Machi.
Yeah.
That was a nice play.
First time Hunter Machi's got to.
It is, yeah.
Let's get a score here. Come on.
First time Devin's looked like a D1 quarterback so far.
Mm-hmm. Quarterback power.
Yeah. As Jamal gets stopped at the line there. As the clock 40 seconds now, Duhawks just a touchdown here just make the score look a little better.
Yeah, they really can't go in today. Like you said, the problems with the offensive line it's kind of limited them. Defense played good, Tiggy good, Ty.
Devin brought down about a yard or two out from the end zone.
You have to go fast right here if they want to.
I'm almost thinking that if that wasn't the last play, then this will be the last play.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Yeah. 4 seconds, come on, get it off. 3, 2, 1.
Snap off. Jamal's almost sums out. Going for the Duhawks that last play.
Yep, poetic ending, I guess you could say.
What would you say won the game today? Oak Blue Golds.
The pressure they were able to get on Siggy. Mm-hmm. They were in the backfield hitting him every single time he went to run for it. But the defense played good, and look it. They hailed a guy who had 365 rushing yards.
Probably the standout player for them today, too.
Yeah.
Him or the quarterback. Quarterback played really well.
Quarterback played well.
Jonathan Mollig, yeah.
Austin Bielak played well, and then their tight end also played really well, and they kept hitting him on those quick little routes.
And then, thanks for tuning in to today's episode of Live Sports. Saturday, September 8:00, we'll be live right here in the Rock Bowl, covering the Loras taking on City University. That's when you won't miss.